Okay, buddy, this is a hijack. Take this elevator to Harlem. Hey, how'd you do in the poker game, Andy?
Okay, fine.
Hey, when are you and Daddy coming over to the house to try out my new barbecue?
Oh, soon, real soon.
5 Saturdays in a row, I asked you. I'm beginning to think you all don't like us.
Oh, but don't be silly. It's just that...
Okay, then we'll expect you next Saturday at 5 o'clock, and no more excuses about the children being sick.
Actually, Dottie hasn't been feeling well.
Get her cured by the weekend. Sluts, sluts, all of you sluts! Next thing you know, you'll be smoking cigarettes. Hello there, Erica, you gorgeous hunk of Sweden.
Norway,
Sweden, what difference does it make as long as you're a blonde? Are you?
Just curious.
I mean, how many girls are really blonde all the way? Collars and cuffs?
Excuse me, Mr. Gerber, but I must get back to my desk.
$1 if you walk fast and stop short. $2 if you trot, $5 if you run, and $10 if you're really a blonde.
Gerber, in here!
Yes, Mr. Townsend! And $50 if you're a fella!
The top of the morning here, Mr. Townsend, and
how Gerber, sit down and stop being so damned happy. It's depressing.
Yes, sir.
Gerber, I am not going to mince words. You have turned in a very disappointing month.
Well, I must say I agree with you, but considering the time of year...
Look, I'm just pointing out it's a subproductive month. I'm not asking why.
It's income tax time, and though people die, they seldom buy.
Gerber, look, I may as well come right out and say this. It's time somebody told you...
I got bad breath. Bad breath!
You got something much worse than that.
Offensive perspiration, midriff bulge, dingy dentures, Asiatic crud.
That's exactly that kind of a remark. You, Gerber, are a smartass. A number one king-size smartass.
I'm the best salesman in this office.
You were, but your rate of new policies is dropping.
Here I've been going about particularly trying to sell policies only to younger men who can live longer and pay premiums longer. And you don't appreciate me. Anybody can sell a policy to a 90-year-old man with a cough and the shingles.
Listen to me, Gerber. Your customers curl up their toes at the same rate as all of our other customers.
Yeah, well, of course. If 23 of my customers go down in a sailing boat accident, that's bound to raise the mortality rate.
What sailing boat?
In the squall.
What squall?
No. It was the train. The train. 33 of them went right off the trestle.
What train?
Would you believe a tidal wave in Kansas City? A volcano in Poughkeepsie. Mass suicides and fire islands.
Gerber!
Oh, okay. Mr. Townsend, about your bread. Hey, look, make it easy on yourself. Home, office, your house. Okay, then, Tuesday, 5:30. Very good. Good show. See you then, John. 6 out of 6, the kid does tricks. Clark Dunwoody, please. Oh, hi. Hey, Clark. Jeff Gerber, Superior Standard Life. Hey, how about that lunch I've been promising you, huh? Good show. Anytime you say.
Local black leaders doing their utmost to keep their pledge to the mayor. Police are ready to...
What are you trying to prove with all that running?
Don't bug me, Althea. I had a traumatic day. 13 appointments out of 15 calls. Is that all you watch? Race riots? What are you, perverse?
It's an important problem.
Was it us that should a request be made for federal intervention? Army units would be immediately made available
to... I was watching.
I'm going to have my dinner without watching a bunch of uppity darkies jigging up and down on my TV screen.
Why are you so hateful?
I'm not hateful, and don't start telling me I have a personality problem.
I said no such thing. I merely tried to point out that there is an issue in this country today that has to do with the equal rights of men.
What kind of dinner is this? What kind of dinner is this? Huh? Eskimos chew on blubber.
There goes your old persecution complex. Whenever you're hurt, attack. Well... That's what this is all about! I don't want you staying up too late, Burton. You should have done that this afternoon. Go to sleep, dear. Maybe tomorrow morning I'll let you watch your father run out of the house.
Why can't he walk like everybody else?
Perhaps he's afraid somebody will catch him.
Kids at school laugh at him. They call me son of Speedy.
Why does Daddy race buses, Mommy?
Nobody seems to know, dear.
Is it like some people save stamps?
Yes, exactly. Some people save stamps, some make model airplanes, some drink, some smoke pot. Well, your father races buses.
If he smoked pot, he'd get there faster.
Good night, children.
$37,000 on the open market.
Oh, that's nice.
That's 17% more than we paid for it.
You need a haircut. Oh. Aren't we going to get ready for bed early tonight? It's Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Mm-hmm.
It's Monday.
Let's pretend it's Wednesday. Oh. Forget it. I'm going to bed. You'll know where to find it.
Yes. You're not watching the riots.
Haven't started yet.
What's the movie?
I don't know.
What's the commercial?
I don't know.
Keep yourself pretty well informed, don't you?
I think we have to face up to something.
Oh, look, don't start.
You can't stand the sight of me.
I can't, so.
You can't stand to touch me.
Wrong again.
There's no passion in our life.
There's plenty of passion in our life.
Let's pretend it's Wednesday.
Huh? Look, sweetie, I've had a hard day.
I know you're tired, but at least let me wake up on your side of the bed like we used to Thursday mornings. Janice was born, we stopped going to bed.
Now, that's an exaggeration. We can't afford more than two children. Unless we have six at one time. That way, everything's free. And we can give them all away except the spotted one.
We can make love without having children, you know. There are methods. There are devices.
They're not foolproof.
They are if you use them all at the same time.
I'm not making love to any heavy tank.
I've still got some good years left, Jeff.
Oh, Jesus.
I take something. And I wear something. And I keep count. And if you... Jeff! Jeff!
Get away.
Yes, Ralph, I know. It's lovely.
Being with you, Sylvia.
Being with you, Ralph.